Eurozone crisis is a crisis that began with the credit of the sovereigns because of enormous debt accumulated over years and years and years of profligate spending, which has morphed into a banking crisis as the banks have been unable to deal with the European sovereign bonds on their balance sheet, which is creating a broader economic recessionary impact in Europe and ultimately perhaps in the United States.
People have been talking about the possible occurrence of a euro event. The occurrence of such an event would be disastrous because it means that multiple countries in the Eurozone would withdraw from the Eurozone, either unilaterally or in concert, resulting in the collapse of the euro as a currency. Each country would then have to redenominate its currency as a new local currency, creating chaos in the market.
Banks are currently under a lot of regulatory pressure. There's market pressure, but also regulatory pressure. And I think the main issue they're facing is they need to, all of them, raise capital. By June of this year, they need to raise 9% regulatory capital. And that's a big number to ask for. At the low end of estimates, that's 109 billion euros they need to raise. So it is a big ask. Banks have been working hard at this, and I think that, you know, they're going to get there, but it's definitely a lot of pressure, a lot that needs to get done by June. So I think that's probably the main issue banks are facing right now.
The crisis in Europe is going to have an impact on U.S. investors and U.S. banks in probably one of two ways. There's first an offensive strategy that they will have. What can we buy and where can we invest? And there's already been a number of transactions in that regard where U.S. investors have recapitalized European banks, or U.S. investors and U.S. banks have bought assets out of European banks. The defensive side of this for U.S. investors, and particularly U.S. banks, is to disclose, understand, and evaluate the impact that this euro crisis is having on them from the point of view of counterparty relationships, derivatives, liquidity, and other things that U.S. regulators may be very interested in knowing about.
When evaluating a potential recapitalization transaction, it's important that the investor not be viewed as taking control of the organization. As a controlling investor, the Bank Holding Company Act would apply restrictions to the fund generally, including restrictions on non-banking activities and investments, restrictions on leverage and requirements regarding capital adequacy, and also source of strength requirements with respect to the institution.
Market parties should be doing now a comprehensive review of their trading and brokerage contracts and collateral arrangements relating to Eurozone transactions and parties. They may be able to effect amendments, if necessary, to existing documentation, or at the very least, insist on protective terms for new transactions and future business. We're working proactively with clients to understand all of the legal and contractual variables in the case of a euro event, and to plan and implement mitigation measures.
One person's loss is another person's gain. For every seller, there is a buyer. This creates enormous opportunities for people who have capital and who are able to absorb risk and want to deploy that capital into the financial sector.